name is Hamza Sonny Bill Williams. So his Muslim name, so to speak, the Arabic name is Hamza. I've known him for many years, and at the same time, I've met him quite a few times. The last was just 3 weeks ago when I drove up to Newcastle in the UK. I was in the UK, and I drove up to Newcastle to meet him because, you know, just to give him that boost and to show him that, look, we do support him and so on, in the sense that I might not be an ardent rugby follower, as people might you know, think, but I'm supporting a particular individual who happens to be a brilliant Muslim who doesn't miss a salah, so to speak. If you search for him, he's on Twitter, actually. And on Twitter, you will see clearly he's got a verse of the Quran at the top. And if you go through his timeline, you'll notice what he does. And you can see he's an open, clear, proud Muslim, mashallah. So I think it just requires people to just look for him a little bit and to just see who exactly he is, and they'll figure out. There's so many Muslims who don't know that he's actually a Muslim. But alhamdulillah, he's a really, really wonderful person. I've known him, like I said, for quite a while, close range. You know, we communicate very often, and mashallah, some of it is even done online just so that people know that, you know, he does have links with a few people whom he asks questions to, and he does have a few concerns, and he does get guidance from the Islamic scholars, so to speak. He's so selfless that I can let you in on something else. There are so many people, especially in Cape Town, where they come, you know, they used to come often for rugby, even when he came for the Crusaders and so on, who have his kit, his boots, and a few other things. He just gives things away, you know, and people know this. So it's not like he did it as a stunt. Some people were saying, oh, it was just a publicity stunt. And I think the media, you know, really made it clear that this was not a publicity stunt, because he was already so popular and he didn't need the popularity, but it was something that came from his heart. And definitely, he does have a good heart. Like I said, he did say that Islam has played the, you know, the biggest role. What it's done for him in the inside, he cannot even explain.
Let's move to my second topic, the topic of my brother, Sonny Bill Williams, mashallah. Sonny Bill Williams is in Umrah, and subhanallah, he has fulfilled his Umrah, and I'm so happy for him. What a lovely brother, really, really great brother. Now, he put up some pictures sharing, obviously encouraging people, sharing his experience and what he felt like, and, you know, the fact that he's in Mecca and Medina. And I think that was the best thing he could have done, was to share these images with the rest of the world, so that people are inspired, so that people can get to learn, so that people know that, you know what, there is so much that we have as Muslimin, and people of different ethnicities, people coming together, and people can be Muslim. It's irrelevant what your color is, what your background is, what your financial standing is, what you do for a living is all irrelevant. You're a Muslim. It's beautiful. So something, my brothers and sisters, you need to know is, when he puts up a post, or anyone puts up a post, remember, your comments need to be decent. You don't have to pick on something that you don't even know about. People are speaking about the tattoo, number one. He's had the tattoo from way before he was a Muslim. And you know what? Why don't we think for a moment, take out the tattoo, take out the tattoo. Relax, take it easy. You don't have to do that to a person. So he is a beautiful brother. Just say, mashallah, alhamdulillah, brother, may Allah bless you, may Allah bless us too, please remember us in your dua. Comments like those are the comments of a mu'min, a Muslim. You don't just pick on something. Do you make like he doesn't know? Do you make like he did it intentionally after he became a Muslim to defy Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No way, no way. So please take it easy. Just like you wouldn't like someone to judge you in your little errors and mistakes. That wasn't even an error or a mistake. It was something prior to Islam. Remember that, guys. So please, when we comment, comment well. Another thing is, what I find interesting is a lot of the non-Muslims have had better comments than some of the Muslims, where people then said, oh, you're not allowed to take pictures in the haram. Relax. Do you know the rule? Do you know that I actually sought permission from the guys to say, can I take a picture? And they say, for as long as you're not disturbing others, you may do so. The rule is, while you're doing tawaf and you're engaged in tawaf and you have the people holding their phones up, you know, and trying to disturb everybody else, bumping into people. No, if you find yourself a little corner, you find yourself something, you know, a place where you want to take a photograph, there's no problem, there's no harm. I mean, for as long as it did not disturb your umrah and it did not disturb other people's umrah. Umrah, and it didn't disturb any act of worship, it's okay. There's no harm. Right now I'm speaking to you. I mean, what's the big deal? I'm not missing my salah. I hope I'm not missing disturbing anyone else's ibadah. I'm not, tampering with any one of your acts of worship. I'm just trying to present a good message. And you have to understand that that's something permissible. I mean, the same applies. Don't pick on the negatives. And like I said earlier, don't just criticize things. And someone told me, okay, criticism might be to highlight something that's correct, that's true. No, what we meant was something else. What I meant is, you just pick on the negatives. You don't even know. Speak about the brother, give him hope and courage. To me, that was one of the best pictures on my timeline. I retweeted it on Twitter because I felt so proud. I felt, you know what? It's really, really good. And it's an inspiration for the whole globe. His reach is far more diverse than mine or anyone else's. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you guys. I thought I'd speak about Sonny Bill Williams because he's an inspiration to all of us. Look at the diversity within his own life. He's got family members who are non-Muslim, a beautiful relationship with them, beautiful relationship with everybody else. In his rugby, he has a brilliant relationship with everyone. He fulfills whatever he can in the best possible way, trying his best not to compromise his Islamic identity. He's always out there. He doesn't need to do things the way you and I think he should. No, he is his own independent person. For as long as he believes that this is my duty unto Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and this is how I should be doing things, alhamdulillah, if we have some good words, perhaps of encouragement, etc., we can say that to him. Another very interesting point is, when you do wrong, you would not like someone to come and smash you and damage you from a public platform. You would like them to encourage you in the most beautiful possible way, like your children, like your own brother or sister. You need to know that you should be doing the same. If there was something wrong, you should correct it in the most beautiful way, my brothers and my sisters. So I hope that was something beneficial. Sonny Bill Williams, mashallah, may Allah bless the man and may Allah make him truly an inspiration for